we're living in. Let me tell ya. And it's a world that man can eat at all, when things are big that should be small. Who can tell what magic spells we'll be doing for us? And I'm giving up my love to this world, only to be told I can't see, I can't breathe, nor my will we be. And nothing's gonna change the way we live, cause we can always take but never give. And now the things are changing for the worse. See, whoa, it's a crazy world we're living in, and I just can't see that half of us.
This is a 10-inch chef's coupe's knife. It's a long spine, a heel, and a rosewood handle. The purpose of this knife is to chop, and the heel allows your hands to move freely. This is a filleting knife. It is used for filleting fish. As you can see, the blade bends and is flexible for filleting fish easily. It should not be used for chopping vegetables, as you are very likely to cut yourself with it. This is a boning knife. As you can see, it's got a red handle, which signifies it's for preparing meat. It is designed to enable you to grip it well and to get into the channels around bones. This is a palette knife. It is suited to a number of tasks. One is to pick up items with it to turn over, so. Two, you're able to spread cream around gattos, and you're able to smooth the top of a gatto with it. This is a carving knife with a serrated edge, ideal for carving bread. Not suitable really for hot meat, but it may be used for carving cold meat easily. This is a basic small prep knife, sometimes known as a paring knife. It is ideal for preparing vegetables and trimming and cutting fruit. It may also be used on a board to slice items thinly. This is a basic peeler and is ideal for peeling vegetables and fruit. As you can see, the process is about holding the fruit carefully and peeling backwards. You have a point in the end to be able to remove eyes from potatoes. This is a butcher's steel and is used for sharpening knives. This is the first way to sharpen a knife. To slide the knife at 45 degrees on each side of the steel. This is method 2, which is to place the steel on the knife firmly in the same manner. And this is method 3. Some chefs prepare to do it as well.